over the last 5 years, overseas development funding for fisheries has declined by 30% in favor of agricultural food products and forestry. Over the same period, funding volumes have seen a dramatic decline when it comes to fisheries research in particular. So you can see that over the last 5 years, investment in fisheries research has gone down in favor of fisheries policy and administrative management. And I think if we want to build our fish stocks that is based on science, development aid is not really doing much. Fish provides us with protein. 60% of our animal protein requirements in Ghana come from fish, not from any food crop, and contributes 4.5% to GDP. All things being equal, the fishery sector provides an average revenue of $1 billion each year. And I always make reference to comparing the industry with oil and gas and mining. Fisheries gives us about, let's say, 5% of our country's GDP. Oil and gas gives 6% of GDP. Unfortunately, it employs just about 400,000 people, while the fisheries sector employs 10% of Ghana's population, which is about, we're talking about 2 million plus. Is that for a vital sector, which has been alluded to by USAID? The waters of Ghana, aside all the fishing, also provides potential for tourism. That's great potential for inland game fishing, annual regattas, which we are not even exploring. The growth in the sector peaked from 2005, but then there has been some concomitant reverse in some years. And interestingly, the lowest time that we had, abysmal growth in the fishery sector was in 2011, which experts think that coincided with the oil production in Ghana. Given that background, I now want to use the time to talk about USAID's technical and financial assistance and what the project is doing. USAID support was designed in 2014 to support the management of Ghana's fisheries and coastal resources on a sustainable basis to enhance Ghana's social and economic development. The first had to do with strengthening the capacity of the University of Cape Coast in developing quality programs in fisheries and coastal management, and then establish a practical research and advisory support base through the Center for Coastal Management. USAID funding is $5.5 million, while UCC is contributing $1.8 million in kind. And that has to do with our time, the space, the resources, other resources, material resources, including electricity, water, along with computer to do that. The Department of Fisheries and Aquatic Science, the lead implementer and the beneficiaries are students, academic, government agencies, private sector, policymakers, fishers, and coastal communities. Now, our project fits into the development of the P2, which is sustainable, providing sustainable and broad-based economic growth. And we are looking at improving the management of Ghana's marine and coastal resources on a sustainable basis. Once we do this, as the head of the department mentioned, we collaborate closely with SFMP and CSRP. We have some overlapping activities which we do together. And to be able to achieve our objective of having expanded capacity, what we do is that we're looking at organization and human capacity expanding, and then we are also providing information to knowledge for natural resource management. So under this first one, we've been able to improve our infrastructure, we've been able to increase technical and scientific knowledge, and we are still doing that. We are engaging in marine and coastal research assessments, working with other relevant government and private sector agencies, and we are also expanding our communication and outreach. So for instance, we have a network with over, 15 media houses working with 20 journalists. We operate a WhatsApp platform, and we are in touch with them, get to us, and advise them on a regular basis. So in terms of project objectives and implementation, what we have achieved over the last 3 years, Mission Director, I'm happy to report that as part of our target outcomes, the key ones I've highlighted are three. strengthen scientific and technical knowledge in fisheries and coastal management. And that through that, we are able to improve nutrition, resilience, poverty reduction, and governance of our natural areas. And then the third part, enhancing our scientific knowledge and communication for marine research assessments. So looking at figure one, training of students, BSc, MPhil, and PhD. Over the last 3 years, we have admitted and trained 124 students in total, BSc 88. And talking about BSc, we've extended the support to other sister universities, the Yale University, and the UBS, where the final year students, at least five of them, are supported in that mandate to be able to effectively conduct their research. That can feed into our fish company, the Analita, spoke about as well, the PepsiCo. So for the BSc 88, MPhil 20, we've admitted the first batch have graduated out of the project at the master's level. The PhD, we are training 16 of them. But I think Susan will be happy to see the graphic, to see that the females are about 50% or more compared to the males. So, that is it for the training of the students. Now, when we go to the short courses, that is being spearheaded by the Center for Coastal Management, we've been able to train a total of 178 government practitioners in private sector, including development agencies that participated in our short courses. Climate Change Adaptation, 79. GIS, both the introductory and intermediate courses, 48 people. ICZM, Integrated Coastal Management, 26, and Fisheries Management, 25. But it's interesting to note that we have placed emphasis on the local assemblies, the district assemblies. They cover nearly 25% of our support because we feel that governance at the local level is extremely important. And particularly for what we do in fisheries and coastal management, you know, it's a very technical field. We were surprised to know that most of the officers are not trained, even within the Fisheries Commission and NOFA. We don't have any fisheries background. So we have brought people from the Fisheries Commission, 10%, NGOs, civil society, the ministries, Ministry of Tourism, Sanitation, the new Ministry of Sanitation and Water Resources, Ministry of Environment, and a number of ministries have participated in our training program. Security agencies, we brought in that covers about 18%, talking about the game. The Forestry Commission, 2%. And of course, academia. Some colleagues within the university and outside the university have also participated in short courses. Figure 3, talking about supplementary library program. This is an area that is we are learning and evolving because there are challenges working with natural systems, creating supplementary libraries around the green economy. Beekeeping, snail rearing have been the focus. Beekeeping, obviously, for honey production. And we have done this, and we are still doing that in four communities, two in the central region and two in the western region. And we are happy to say that we have so far supported 113 people, training them with experts from the University of Cape Coast, Department of Conservation Biology and Entomology. And now these people are ready now to start their own farms. So within the current year, we are going to empower them to establish their own farm. The idea is to let them reduce the pressure on fishing so that they can go into other economic activities within the fishing community. Now, what excites me most is the FishCom Ghana. FishCom Ghana is an online platform, thanks to Dr. Champong and Dr. Nubuasari for this wonderful initiative. It's the first of its kind in the country. It's an online platform, fishcomghana.com. And of course, Joshua, yes, they have been the very strong. Presently, we've been able to document that in current works that are ongoing, 374 documents on Ghana's fisheries. It's primarily Ghana's information on fisheries data hub. We have 198 documents on marine fisheries, 84 on coastal fisheries, freshwater 92 documents. And we are happy to say that so far there has been almost 80,000 visits to the site. But actually, visitors are 10,000, and that is very interesting when you saw the analysis. And the other data on the countries, we've gone beyond Ghana. You see that Indonesia, we have received a lot of visitation from Indonesia. We don't know why, but apparently, Indonesia seems to have some similarities in terms of our party systems. Sourcing and procurement is also a problem for us. You know, we have to go through the university system, following the Ghana's procurement regulations, and we know how that can be tedious. We do have a short-term technical assistance from experts outside the university, and these are normally consultants whom we bring in to fast-track certain areas of our work. Unfortunately, some of them have delivered very slowly, and this has been some of our challenges which we are trying to overcome. We do have limited hands to implement the project, but I must commend the research assistants for the good work that they are doing. Most of them have committed their time in a very good way. But we think that the university, given that the dean is here, can help us fast track employment of some of these research assistants. Of course, some of the graduates will be coming out of our programs, will have to join the postdoc programs at the center and also the fisheries department. Now let me quickly go to the contribution of what we are doing to USAID in terms of the increased competitiveness of major food value chains. We've been able to strengthen scientific and technical capacity, not just for the students, but for the staff as well, where the University of Rhode Island has played a very critical role in supporting the training of our students through the dual degree program, which has also been approved by the university, and some of our staff, professors who are benefiting from training in the US. We have been able to support nutrition, given the work in the communities, and over the long term, resilience building, poverty reduction and governance in our coastal areas. We have enhanced scientific knowledge through FishCom Ghana, and also through training of over 100 students who are going to become the next generation of leaders in the fishery sector. What we are concerned about is as to whether government would be prepared to absorb it. So I think this is where, at the high level, the ministry and the MOFAD need to be prepared to absorb all these students so that they can be very effective in driving forward our fisheries agenda. Now, in moving forward, these are priority recommendations to the mission director. So the chances of recovery in our marine fisheries is not guaranteed, unfortunately, even though it is possible, because the sector is very complex. It may happen in the near future, but also it may not happen. It's a variable situation we cannot predict, because given the practices on the ground, the illegalities that are going on, both from the foreign and local firms, we cannot really guarantee that. But at least, we should still continue the investments along marine fisheries in a sustainable way. But once we do this, just like with the global scenario I showed, we must couple such investment with aquaculture, which is very paramount. Academia needs to be empowered to work with government and industry to reduce cost of aquaculture operation by training extension agents, also doing research to feeds, which currently we are not doing. You know, and then to be able to demarcate productive areas in lakes and rivers as a way of contributing to the marine program. The second has to do with promoting research into other important fish stocks. And here I mentioned sepia, I mentioned catfish, because these are extremely important. Sepia offers opportunity to begin looking at mariculture. Within our lab, we have started work on cuttlefish. The last has to do with connecting the Center for Coastal Management to government more effectively, private sector and local community institutions for sustainable marine fisheries management, providing the national platform. And here, we are working with the Ghana Museums and Monuments Board to locate the center as well for St. Jago. The concept is this, that we want to be directly within the community so that the interactions with the community as part of our sustainable fisheries management program for the University of Cape Coast will be able to advance the issues further. I'll be happy to share more light about that new project, which is just coming out of this USAID funding. support program as well. So, landlords, I wish to thank you all for your attention.